50 years in a single band. This is something that only a very small handful of people can say that they've accomplished. Drummers like Charlie Watts of the Rolling Stones, or Roger Taylor of Queen, and Frank Beard of ZZ Top are all in this exclusive club. But there's another drummer who's not far away from hitting this same milestone, and that's Larry Mullen Jr., who's been with U2 for 45 years now.
And it's possible, I can tell you, it is possible to do this in your sleep.
His drumming has had a huge impact on the overall sound of U2's music. With nearly 200 million album sales throughout U2's career, he's had a massive influence on drummers, musicians, and music fans around the world, be it touring the world with U2 or being featured in episodes of The Simpsons or even Friends. So, in this video, I'm gonna break down some of Larry Mullen's most famous drum parts, some of which you won't find anywhere else on the internet. Trust me, I've looked. Let's get right into it and get started with the first one.
Sunday, Bonnie, Sunday.
So there you just heard a clip of U2 playing Sunday, Bloody Sunday in 1985. This is hands down one of their most famous songs, and by far the most famous Larry Mullen Jr. groove. So we have two 16th notes picking up into that first bar, and the thing with this groove is the entire thing is played as single strokes alternating between the right hand and the left hand. You've got a quarter note pulse happening on the kick all the way through that really just drives it home. Next, we have the opening track from U2's The Joshua Tree from 1987. And this was their first album that really gave them international recognition, and it was just a massive commercial success. So this track opens the album, and according to Larry Mullen Jr., it was really tough to get this song to sit right in the studio. And Larry says it really only became a truly great song through playing it live. So here we're just gonna break down four bars from one of the choruses from the clip we watched earlier from the U2 360 tour. We're gonna play this on the side snare with the snares in the off position so it sounds kind of like a tom. The other thing you'll notice is that everything is played hand to hand as single strokes, a very common thing we see in Larry Mullen's playing. So that was a clip from the song With or Without You. That was the rattle and hum version from 1988, but the song was originally released on the Joshua Tree back in 1987. This one is really cool because it's something that we don't see a lot of the time. Larry Mullen Jr. is playing pretty much this entire groove right-handed over on the left side floor tom and working his way over to the snare like this, and only adding in the left hand when there's 16th notes. So when you think about it, Larry Mullen Jr. being a right-handed drummer, this really does make sense that every note is played with the right hand. But it kind of gets you inside the mind of where Larry Mullen Jr. was at back in 1988, and it's just a really cool pattern to practice authentically the way that Larry played it. So this is Bullet the Blue Sky, another track from the Joshua Tree from 1987. And there's a really cool story about how they actually recorded this drum track and got the sound that you hear on the record. Basically, Larry Mullen went into the studio, recorded his track, then they set up a PA system in a warehouse at Windmill Lane Studios and played the drum track through the PA, mic'd it up, and recorded it there. And that's how you get this really boomy, sound with a lot of reverb in it, and it really sounds like a John Bonham style kit, which is really, really cool and different from anything else you hear on the record. So, what we have going on here is an eighth note pattern on the hats And you're gonna wanna play a bunch of rim shots when playing all of those notes on the snare. There's some hi-hat openings in there too, so watch for those. Here we go. Next one is a bit of a deeper cut and one that you won't find literally anywhere else on the internet. This is the opening track from The Unforgettable Fire called A Sort of Homecoming. And what you'll see on this kit here, I have a timbale, I have a side snare, and this is all stuff that Larry Mullen Jr. used in the early 80s. Basically what we have here is a single stroke pattern all the way through, even though there's some other ways that you could play this with some different stickings, but Larry Mullen would have played this as singles. We have some stuff going up to the rack tom, over to the timbale, and then even some crossovers happening between the side snare and the main snare here. And what's really cool about this is, for any of you who grew up listening to 70s and 80s rock music, patterns like this were completely different from what you would hear on most records in that era. So this was something that really sparked my interest in the band and really just got me thinking about different ways to approach the instrument. So here we're looking at track two off of The Unforgettable Fire. This is the song Pride in the Name of Love, one of the most famous U2 songs from their entire career. And what's really cool about this one, again, we have the left side floor tom being involved, something that Larry Mullen actually did quite often, and still to this day, he tours with a floor tom on his left side. We have some offbeats played on the hats, which is kind of cool because usually we'd expect to just have straight eighth notes. And then we also have some hi-hat openings happening as well. One of the things you'll notice when I play that is, to play that left side floor tom, I'm actually bringing my right hand down to play the backbeat and then playing with my left hand over here right after. And that's kind of nice because then you don't have to cross over or anything like that. So that was a clip from the song Beautiful Day from the album All That You Can't Leave Behind. This is one of the band's most performed songs. I believe they've played it at almost every concert since the Elevation tour in 2001. So when you play along to the recording, you'll hear that that kick and snare pattern is right locked in with all of the other instruments in that section, which is really cool, and it really makes this groove musical. It makes sense for what's happening in the song. So that concludes our lesson on Larry Mullen Jr., one of my all-time favorite drummers. And hopefully some of these grooves kind of allowed you to think differently about how you orchestrate things around the kit or create grooves that make musical sense. Because that's really what makes Larry Mullen so great. He has the ability to create grooves that work for the song. So now I'd love to hear from you. What is your favorite U2 song or Larry Mullen Jr. drum part? Leave some comments below, share it with the rest of the community. And when you're listening to those suggestions, listen for how Larry's part fits into the music as a whole. So with that, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Cheers.